Hello, everybody. Welcome back to E20 Zone TV. I hope you're having a very, very good day wherever you are. It's currently lunchtime, UK time. I'm here to talk about David Moyes and why he's so hated amongst his fan base. Before I get started, please do smash a like on the video, subscribe to E20 Zone TV, hit notification bell and all that. And yeah, let's get into this. Who is really to blame for this situation at West Ham currently right now? Is it David Moyes or is it David Sullivan? Yeah, I done a video about 5 months ago in regards to this. Yeah, and I turned around and said that David Sullivan is the root of the problem at West Ham. But after the last sort of 24, 48 hours, I've seen so much heat on social media. People just keep going in at the manager, in at the manager, in at the manager. On Thursday night, he had a decision to make, which I thought was the right one. Yeah, he had to go low block FC against a side that was struggling to get through. Yeah, let's have it right. This team, yeah, scored from two set pieces. Yeah, didn't play through the middle of us. So defensively, we was all right. Yeah, up until they scored. You know what I mean? And it's just the lack of respect that just kills me, really. That's the one thing that really sort of really grinds into me. There's not liking Moyes, don't get me wrong, and there's not sort of thinking to yourself, right, he's not the future. He is not the future, yeah? For me, I think it may be time to say goodbye, but I respect the geezer. I respect the geezer for what he's done, yeah? And I respect the journey that West Ham has been on over the last few years. When I look at social media, especially, and I look at people just keep venting and venting and venting at David Moyes, yeah? And I had it on the afterthought the other day. Yeah, someone come on the afterthought, started saying about Moyes. I just flipped. I just flipped. I've just about had enough now. Yeah, because there's been Moyes out, and I've spoke to many people. Yeah, I've spoke to many gentlemen who are proper West Ham fans through and through, claret and blue, home and away. And they've said, James, he's just not the guy for us. Yeah, he's done well. And we respect him for that, but it's time for a change in the summer. Totally get that. Totally respect that. And that's the right way of doing things. And then there is just people who are just can't wait. They just cannot physically wait to get on social media and start blasting the manager out of the ground. Yeah. And I just think that's not right. I really do. Right. I think a lot of the hatred goes on to Moyes, but Sullivan gets a pass. Now, the question is, why does David Sullivan consistently get a pass? Yeah. Last summer, June the 8th, day after Prague, he's on TalkSport talking about Declan Rice and how much money he wants for that man. Yeah. If he was an ambitious owner like Aston Villa, like Newcastle, and he had that sort of mindset, he would have made a decision on David Moyes. He would have turned around and said, right, we'll either back him or sack him. He done neither. Done nothing. Yeah, he sits there and sat on his hands. And for me, when he done that, it just tells Georgie all you need to know. So he winds the man's contract down to then offer him a new one. This makes no sense to me, right? And for me, when I look at him, he is the problem. The January window come round. And we're all thinking to ourselves, the first thing West Ham fans thought in the January window, left winger. Need a left winger. Need to get rid of Saïd Benrahma and bring in a left-sided attacker in. Yeah? We get rid of Saïd Benrahma. No left-sided attacker. We get rid of Pablo Fornals. Now, Pablo Fornals wasn't one of my most favourite players, but he used to give everything for the shirt as best as he could. Right? We get rid of him for £6 million. Yeah? Why? Like, we need players, and we're getting rid of everyone. Right? Obviously, Tilo Kehrer went to Monaco, and obviously, Connor Coventry, right, who was just like, wasn't even a player really at West Ham. It was just there. It means like, it was like the ghost of Christmas past. And the January window, West Ham go out and chase two targets. Jota in Saudi Arabia, ex-Celtic, and Osmond at a Danish club. Yeah. One of them has got agents problems and one of them's got tax problems. And it's just ironic that both of them have got problems, isn't it? Like, you've got millions of players out there on the planet, and you go for two players that you know you can't get. People are blaming David Moyes for that, saying he had this, 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 and this, right? David Moyes was offered nine players. Well, there was two players there, but no one mentions about them two players. because that's not, that doesn't do anything towards David Moyes. Yeah. Stuyvesant wanted Osmond. Yeah. Moyes wanted Osmond. Right. Even Mark Noble wanted Osmond. Yeah. Some of the fans, including myself, wanted Osmond. But David Sullivan said no. Right. Oh, I ain't going for Osmond. Right. No, I ain't going to do it. It's like with agents and shit like that. And then the Jota thing comes up, and it comes up with a tax problem. And I'm thinking, because well, obviously he being in Saudi Arabia and the tax issue over there, something to do with the tax issue where it would have been difficult to get the deal done. Yeah, because I think he signed or whatnot. And yeah, something to do with a tax issue. Right. I did read it before. There you go. Like, what more proof do you need? It happened 2 years ago with Rafinha and Phillips. You chuck money out there. You go, oh, well, we're going to put a bid in. But you're putting a bid in that you know that's going to get rejected, right? It's like me going out and trying to buy a £500,000 house and only sticking a bid of 150 grand. Ain't going to work, mate. I'm sorry, it's not going to happen, is it? But we tried FC. But we tried Mr. Sullivan. Do you know what I'm saying? It's just, the issue is people have got to start looking further afield. And the thing was, I'll tell you what, I'm going to say this. The Nottingham Forest game, when the banners come out, and then the banner comes out for GSB, out. Why is that banner not out all the time? Why is that GSB banner not out consistently anymore? The reason why it's not out consistently anymore is because David Moyes is the manager that has made us go up a level, and people have gone, well, this is where we are. We've got no reason to complain. Yeah, now people are venting their anger at David Moyes. And not at the ownership of the club. Yeah. David Moyes, for me, has had a lot of money at West Ham. And I keep getting this sort of told to me every time. 450 million, James. We spent 450 million. Big clubs spend big money. Chelsea spend money. Aston Villa has spent money. Newcastle spent money. Every club spends money. We're no different. Yeah. Have we spent the money right? That's a different argument altogether. Yeah. Have we signed players that haven't worked out? Yeah, of course we have. Yeah, we made mistakes. But we've also signed some gems. Jared Bowen being an absolute one of them. Do you know what I'm saying? So when I look at 450 million, and I look at Chelsea currently right now, spent a billion, and they're nowhere near us, and they really are not. Yeah, people look at their team and look at the individuals, say, yeah, look at the players they've got. Individuals, yes. Team structure, not a chance. Not a chance at all. They are a sinking ship, yeah, and they are prepared to collapse. Right. So when it comes to sort of this sort of attitude between Moyes and the love affair of Moyes, you've got like the Moyes outers, you've got the Moyes lovers, you've got, you know what I'm saying? It's like a pantomime fucking villain, if I'm being honest. Right. Moyes deserves respect. Yeah. He deserves untold amount of respect for what he has done at West Ham United Football Club. He has changed the mindset and the mentality of West Ham fans now. We are not that little West Ham anymore. Yeah, we simply are not. We are a team that are structured better, yeah, to a point with him, yeah. But from the ball structure down, isn't right, because the ball overtake anything that the manager wants. The manager, Moyes, has wanted Eze before he got Benrahma, yeah. And there's been times before where the manager has also solid up on players. Do you know what I'm saying? But I do look at the owner of this club, and I think people just seem to have this impression that you take the manager out, you bring put a new manager in, everything's going to be in the Garden of Eden. It ain't going to wash like that, mate. I'm going to be real. Yeah, West Ham are going to go down before they go back up again. It's as simple as that. We need major investment in this club. We need major restructuring from the top, really, down. And it all starts at the top. Like, I see a lot of stuff on social media and on YouTube. Yeah, it does drive me mad to a point. I see someone today say West Ham are a top five club. Says who? Like, someone tell me how West Ham are a top five club. Now, I'll break it down for you quickly. Yeah, because this video is only going to be quick. West Ham do not have a top five defence. Kurt Zouma and Mavropanos are not top five, yeah, centre-halves. Simon Jordan summed it up brilliantly the other day on TalkSport. When you look at Spurs' centre-half pairing of Romero and Van de Ven, and you look at our centre-half pairing of Mavropanos and Zouma, it's night and day. It is simply night and day. Yeah, there's difference in class. We've got a front three in Kudus, Bowen and Paqueta that can do damage against anyone. Yeah, and I'll give give that. Yeah. But as a squad, we are a top 10 side. Yeah. As I've said before, there's no shame in that. Yeah. That's actually something to be quite proud of. Because considering where West Ham have been before and to where West Ham are right now, that's pretty good going. But people have got this impression that West Ham are this top six, top five side. The reason why they think like that is because David Moyes, the manager currently right now, the one everyone seems to hate quite a lot, has put that in our head to say, we're not that little old West Ham. Yeah, we really are not. When it comes to sort of Upton Park and Stratford, yeah, this is also another thing that I see quite a lot. And I'm going to speak about it now before I wrap this up. When we was at Upton Park, the style of play mattered because West Ham was never competing for anything back in the day. Yeah. All the times that I've seen West Ham over the years, West Ham have had probably a handful of decent seasons. Yeah. Because mainly most of the time, West Ham have been struggling, right? Either mid-table, 10th, or with just fighting relegation for the skin of our teeth. Yeah. The moment we left Upton Park to go to Stratford, we left there for a purpose. That purpose is not to be the same team anymore. It's to be a team that can go on and compete at the highest level. Yeah. And without a lot of money in our time at Stratford, yeah, West Ham has spent a lot of money, right? Under Pellegrini, under Moyes, there's been a lot of dough, even under a little bit under Village. Yeah. But the mindset now is West Ham are a team that is top 10. We are a top 10 side. Right. And the issue is people keep thinking we're that little old West Ham, win or lose. Yeah. We just want to see good football. We don't care if we lose sort of attitude. Well, I do care if we lose. Yeah, I really do. I care deeply when we lose. Right. And it's not nothing to do with rivalry or banter or anything like that. I don't want to see my team losing every week and looking, we look good. Yeah. But we're not doing nothing. What's the point in that? Do you know what I'm saying? Because that would only wash for a certain amount of time. Because if people are going to start moaning at David Moyes' company right now for the amount of money he spent, and he's finished 6th, 7th, 14th trophy, currently 7th right now, it won't be long before people start moaning and saying, look how much money the new manager spent, and we're 12th. We look good, but we're 12th. Yeah? People, you can't go from having a mindset of saying, we're 5th, we're top six material, and then accepting 12th because we look good. It's like having a Ferrari, yeah? I could have the most lovely Ferrari, but if I've got no engine, what's the point? It's as simple as that. Do you know what I mean? It's okay looking good, but you've also got to have the stuff underneath it to make it work. Do you know what I'm saying? And for me, I just don't think we have. I've always said this. I'm going to stick with this to the day that I fucking die, yeah? Sullivan will always be the problem at West Ham. He will always be the problem, yeah? And when people look at other teams, like Aston Villa, for instance, look at their owners. Their owners are ambitious individuals who want their team to be a success. Aston Villa went out and got Unai Emery. West Ham couldn't persuade Unai Emery, yeah? Newcastle's owners, yeah? Lots of money, lots of ambition, right? The question I'm going to leave is this. What is the owner's ambition at West Ham? It's a simple question. What is the ambition of the owners at West Ham United? Now, I could probably tell you that, but I'm going to let you sort of decide in the comments below. But I believe the ambition of West Ham's owners currently right now is content. They are content with being where they are. If West Ham finished 12th, they wouldn't care. Yeah. There is not a standard at West Ham. Yeah. Their standard is do not get relegated. Simple as that. Don't get relegated. And basically be a sort of mid-table side. Yeah. The difference is David Moyes has made us, he's made us into a side that we expect now. We expect to be top 10. And if we're not, why aren't we? So there you go. That's what I think on that. I've always said this, Sullivan is to blame. And Moyes has been pretty good at his time at West Ham. Now, you might not like him. You might think he's an absolute wrong'un. Yeah. The geezer deserves some level of respect. Yeah. I think respect is key in life. Yeah. What you give out, you should receive back. Do you know what I mean? If you're going to give out shit, then you're going to take shit back. As simple as that. And the other night, I just turned around and I just thought, I just had enough. Just completely had enough. I thought, all these people just keep knocking the manager when it's just an easy stick to smash my head with. Do you know what I'm saying? The geezer's not getting sacked. Yeah, he's got another seven, maybe eight games here, right, off the top of my head. And then in the summer, we will all know the truth. I think we'll know before the summer, if I'm being honest. I think yeah, something will be announced probably on the Luton game. It wouldn't surprise me. So there you go. I'm going to leave it at that. I'll be back tomorrow, straight after the game. Fulham, big game. Hopefully we get a result, but we will see. Anyway, if you're doing the Grand National today, and you're a member of the channel, check out my members' stuff. If you want to become a member, by all means, do become a member. And I will see you again in the next one. Au revoir.